It was a two-year journey, but earlier this year, I finally amended the Wild Animals and Birds Act and renamed it the Wildlife Act now. And with that piece of legislation, then we can save a lot more lives in Singapore.
Speaking up to save lives, the Honourable Louis Ng Kok Kwang of Singapore, vegetarian, part 1 of 2. Continue watching to find out more.
Today's episode will be presented in French and English with subtitles in Arabic, Oraxis, also known as Vietnamese, Chinese, English, French, German, Hindi, Indonesian, Korean, Mongolian, Persian, Russian, Spanish, and Thai.
Qu'en fait, qui signifie comment ça va ou quoi de neuf est la manière dont les Guadeloupéens accueillent autrui. Je suis Philippe, noble téléspectateur. Tout comme vous, nous, les insulaires, apprécions profondément Mère Nature, qui nous étonne constamment par ses merveilles, et nous vous remercions de suivre le mode de vie vegan écologique. Bienvenue dans la première partie de notre série de deux épisodes. Militer pour sauver des vies, l'honorable Louis Ng Kok Kwang de Singapour, végétarien. L'honorable Louis Ng Kok Kwang est un membre du Parlement du Parti d'Action Populaire de Singapour. Depuis 2015, il est député représentant la circonscription représentative du groupe Nissen. M. Lui Heng est également le fondateur et directeur général de Animal Conscience Research and Education Society, ou ACRES, une organisation de protection des animaux dont la mission est de créer un monde bienveillant et socialement responsable dans lequel les animaux sont traités comme des êtres sensibles. L'organisation mène des recherches sur l'utilisation des animaux dans divers domaines et utilise ses résultats pour éduquer le public sur le bien-être animal. ACRES encourage la communauté à participer au mouvement de protection des animaux et noue des partenariats avec des organisations connexes. Fondée en 2001, ACRES a été la première organisation non gouvernementale de Singapour consacrée à la protection des animaux. Elle s'est depuis développée à l'international avec des bureaux en Australie et au Laos. Dans son rôle de directeur général d'ACRES, M. Lui Heng travaille sans relâche pour bâtir un monde où les animaux sont traités avec compassion et respect. M. Lui Heng est titulaire d'une maîtrise en conservation des primates de l'université Oxford Brookes au Royaume-Uni. Dans l'émission d'aujourd'hui, M. Lui Heng commence par raconter la fascinante histoire qui l'a amené à devenir politicien.
It began in 2008, actually, when Minister Shanmugam was the guest of honor at the ACRES Gala Dinner. I think, in fact, Loving Heart served the food for the Gala Dinner. He was a guest of honor. I delivered my speech. I came down and he says, why don't we work together? Tell me what obstacles you're facing. Let's work together to try and clear them.
Après cette discussion avec le ministre Shanmugam, M. Lui Heng a commencé à se demander si, en tant que député, il pourrait apporter des changements législatifs qui accéléreraient grandement la protection des animaux. Cette idée l'a finalement incité à débuter son parcours politique.
And with that, it began the different approach for ACRES, where we realized we could not just only confront issues, but we could collaborate as well. And we tried it out. Let's see if we collaborate. What more? Whether we could achieve a lot more. And that's also the point where I realized, yes, we could and we should go on rescuing animals. And it's really one at a time, changing mindsets one at a time through our awareness work as well. But if we also embark on a policy change journey where we can effect legislative change, policy level changes, then we could actually save a lot more animals. We do both concurrently. And that's one reason why I entered politics, so that I can enter parliament, fight for legislative policy changes, ask the questions, and really be there to shape our policies and our legislation. And that's what I've done over the last 5 years. If you know, 14 years ago, I wrote a letter to the Straits. It was a Today forum asking for the Wild Animals and Birds Act to be amended. And now that I'm in parliament, I amended it. Earlier this year, it was a two-year journey, but earlier this year, I finally amended the Wild Animals and Birds Act and renamed it the Wildlife Act now. And with that piece of legislation, we can save a lot more lives in Singapore.
Grâce aux efforts inlassables de l'honorable Louis Heng, le gouvernement singapourien a adopté la loi Wildlife Act en mars 2020. Il s'agit du premier amendement substantiel à la loi sur les oiseaux et animaux sauvages depuis 1965 et il améliore considérablement la protection et le bien-être des animaux sauvages à Singapour. Cette loi interdit à quiconque de piéger, de prendre ou de garder des animaux sauvages sans l'approbation du gouvernement. Ceux qui enfreignent cette loi s'exposent à une amende maximale de 37 800 $ US, à une peine de 2 ans de prison ou aux deux. La loi interdit également la vente ou l'exportation de toute espèce animaux sauvages vivants ou morts, ou de toute partie du corps d'un animal sauvage sans l'approbation du gouvernement. Elle interdit également l'importation de toute espèce d'animaux sauvages sans autorisation. Les contrevenants encourent une amende maximale de 37 800 $ US jusqu'à 2 ans de prison ou les deux. Téléspectateurs aimant les animaux, nous allons maintenant faire une courte pause pour profiter du son apaisant des cascades et nous revenons dans un instant. Veuillez rester sur Supreme Master Television. Joyeux téléspectateurs, bienvenue pour la suite de notre entretien avec l'honorable Louis Ngoc Quang. Malgré son succès remarquable pour faire adopter la loi Wildlife Act par le Parlement de Singapour, M. Li Eng souhaite faire beaucoup plus pour les animaux et notre environnement. En plus de son travail de député, M. Li Eng travaille sans relâche en tant que directeur général des CURS. Il espère qu'un jour, tous les animaux pourront vivre en sécurité et protégés.
Aims and ideals still remain the same. So I remain the same person that started ACRES, the same person that who is an MP now. So as I share with my ACRES team right from the start and very regularly, is that we are in the business of ending our business, which means that hopefully by the time I die, there wouldn't be a need for an ACRES Wildlife Rescue Centre. That the day will come where we don't need to rescue animals. The day will come where we don't need to create awareness about animal welfare issues because everyone is aware of it and passionately fighting for it. Are we at that stage yet? Probably not, but I dare say that a vast proportion of people are now aware of animal welfare issues, environmental issues, and very importantly, they're willing to speak up about it now. As we saw with the SG Climate Rally, where youth are coming forward now, mobilizing people, not just to speak up, but to really take action. And I think that will be sort of the defining moment in activism here in Singapore.
L'honorable Louis Eng félicite les jeunes de son pays pour leur volonté de défendre ce qui est juste et de parler avec ferveur du bien-être animal, des problèmes environnementaux et du changement climatique à travers leur activisme.
So with climate change, we had the SG Climate Rally and I saw an amazing presence of all the youth coming, I think it was a Saturday afternoon, in the hot sun, coming together to speak up about climate change. And I wanted to make sure that that debate continues, not just in the public arena, but now in Parliament. So I'm actually planning the first private member's motion on climate change in Parliament, where we're working with the activists.
Monsieur Li Eng travaille avec diligence pour assurer l'adoption du projet de loi sur le changement climatique. Outre l'appui des jeunes et des militants, il bénéficie d'un soutien encore plus large.
We're working with industry as well to make sure that all these voices will ultimately be heard in Parliament. And then as a Parliament, we come together to debate a motion and hopefully pass the motion that climate change is an important issue, it's existential, and it's something that we really need to fight and tackle.
Honorable Li Eng, merci pour vos efforts diligents visant à protéger notre précieuse planète et nos tendres animaux cohabitants. Puissiez-vous être abondamment béni pour votre gentillesse et votre compassion.
For more information about the Honorable Louis Ngoc Quang, please visit parliament.gov.sg.
Bienvenue pour le dernier épisode de la série. Militer pour sauver des vies, l'honorable Li Ngoc Quang de Singapour, végétarien. L'honorable Li Ngoc Quang est un membre du Parlement de Singapour depuis 2015. Il est aussi le fondateur et directeur général de Animal Concerns Research and Education Society, ou ACRES, une organisation de protection des animaux dont la mission est de créer un monde bienveillant et socialement responsable dans lequel les animaux sont traités comme des êtres sensibles. Tout jeune, M. Li Eng se souciait déjà du bien-être des animaux et de la protection de l'environnement. Dans l'émission d'aujourd'hui, il nous en dit plus sur son enfance.
With environmental animal issues, somehow it's just stuck with me since I was young. My parents always ask why, and don't know, just somehow it clicked to me that when I was young, I knew that there was something that I should do about protecting the environment, about protecting animals, and that's something that I'm very fortunate. At 14, I believe, I realized this was my dream really, to protect animals and environment, and that was what I pursued.
Monsieur Lu Heng est convaincu que les films peuvent être des moyens puissants d'aider les gens à vraiment comprendre l'immense souffrance des animaux. Il se souvient d'un film qu'il a regardé avec sa mère quand il avait 14 ans.
Well, one turning point was the movie Gorillas in the Mist, and it was about this American lady, Diane Fossey, who went to Africa to save gorillas. And I watched that movie with my mom, and of course, halfway through, I turned to her and I said, "Mommy, I want to be just like Diane once I grow up." I remember that was something that really touched me. I shared this story in Parliament as well, about how films really changed people's life, and that film changed my life, and really wanted to be just like Diane once I grew up, to be as passionate as she was, and to really fight for what she believed in. I mean, she gave up everything to fight for her dreams and her passion.
Depuis lors, Monsieur Lu Heng a dévoué sa vie à la protection des animaux et de notre planète. Il est convaincu que c'est un devoir moral pour chacun d'entre nous.
Ultimately, it's our responsibility, and I like to push on the moral ground more, which I think we often don't. Like climate change, we always push it at economic level, that is our dollars and cents, that we have to spend so much now to protect against climate change. But ultimately, it is our moral responsibility to look after these animals, to look after the environment as well, because they depend on us. And much more, of course, we depend on them as well to make sure that this planet to live in.
L'année 2020 a été celle de la pandémie mondiale de COVID-19. Cette zoonose est apparue sur un marché humide où des animaux sauvages étaient abattus et vendus. Pendant plusieurs mois, M. Lu Heng a travaillé à améliorer la situation à Singapour.
So that's one thing I've been fighting for in Parliament really, to really scrutinize what's going on in our wet markets. And the first thing that I've pushed for is to end the sale and slaughter of wildlife. Well, it's the Ministry of Sustainability and the Environment now is reviewing it. They're looking at the wet market issue, and I'm hopeful for positive results soon. So mostly at our wet markets are the turtles that are being imported. They're wild caught as well, and that's the concern that I raised in Parliament, that a lot of these animals are coming in with unknown diseases. They are starved in the process. A lot of them have wounds on them, and that will lower their immunity, and that will increase the chance of disease transmission. And that's why I say it's not also a staple food. It's something that we don't need.
L'honorable Lu Heng Kok Kwang est aussi profondément préoccupé par le changement climatique. Nous lui avons demandé d'en estimer la gravité et de nous dire ce que les particuliers peuvent faire pour aider à sensibiliser davantage les gens.
It is an emergency. It's not just something that we take action, but it really is an emergency that we need to tackle. One thing is to create awareness. So if they speak up and help share the news, we can reach out to more people, empower more people, mobilize them. And that's the most important thing now, to get the momentum going.
Téléspectateurs compatissants, restez avec nous sur Supreme Master Television tandis que nous prions pour la sécurité et la paix de tous les êtres vivants sur Terre. Nous revenons dans un instant. Précieux téléspectateurs, bienvenue pour la suite de notre entretien avec un député bienveillant de Singapour, l'honorable Louis Heng Kok Kwang. En tant que militant dévoué à la cause des droits des animaux, M. Lu Heng partage sa vision pour l'organisation Animal Concerns Research and Education Society, ou ACRES, et pour le Parlement de Singapour.
Well, my vision really is that we can coexist with the animals in the environment. That's the reality in urban Singapore as well, where the animals are venturing out of the nature reserves into the urban landscape, and it's important for us to have that harmony with them, to coexist and to respect each other's spaces. And I think if we can do that and coexist, then it ultimately is a win-win situation.
Monsieur Lu Heng travaille sans relâche à protéger la vie des animaux et à les faire reconnaître en tant qu'êtres sensibles. Quel conseil l'honorable Lu Heng Kok Kwang donnerait-il à ceux qui sont convaincus que les animaux devraient être traités avec compassion et respect?
Well, I think the most important thing is never give up. I've always said that. People always ask me which animal I resemble the most, and I've always said a housefly, because the housefly is very persistent and never gives up. And I think that's crucial now, especially in today's world where we're very short attention span. And I think that if we pursue this passion, pursue our passion, become activists and speak up about this issue and never give up and we persevere, then ultimately we will see changes, which we have seen over the last few decades.
Monsieur Lu Heng s'inquiète non seulement pour les animaux et l'environnement, mais aussi pour les êtres humains vulnérables. Il compte présenter une nouvelle loi au Parlement pour réduire le gaspillage alimentaire et garantir que tous les Singapouriens mangent à leur faim.
I'm also going to push my second private member's bill, so I've amended the Wildlife Act And now I'm working on a Good Samaritan's Food Donation Act, which I think will be crucial, one, in tackling food waste in Singapore, because that always is very painful to see the amount of food that people throw away here. The hotels, the restaurants, supermarkets, good food that can be eaten, but are unfortunately thrown away. And at the same time, being on the ground, I see people, Singaporeans, who are struggling to have 3 meals a day. And I want to try and match and solve both problems, which is through the Good Samaritan's Food Donation Bill. And so it would be a bill that will help to tackle food waste, and I think very importantly, help to provide Singaporeans who struggle to have food as well. And I'm hoping to introduce that bill maybe next year. And the beautiful thing again is we are setting up a committee of individuals from the NGO sector, from the industry, the restaurants, the supermarkets, the hotel. And that's what I really love about this process, where everybody is getting together and it's a ground-up initiative. So not just the government or ministries that can put bills in parliament, but people can come together and we can introduce this as a private member's bill as well.
Vous êtes vraiment une source d'inspiration, honorable Lui Heng Kok Kwang. Pour conclure l'entretien, M. Lui Heng partage quelques mots à propos de notre bien-aimé Maître Suprême Shingai.
Well, thank you for all the good work that she's done. Thank you for all the good food that she's also created at the Loving Heart restaurants. And thank you for making this world a better place for all.
Honorable Lui Heng Kok Kwang, nous sommes vraiment reconnaissants pour votre persévérance et votre engagement à protéger nos précieux amis les animaux, notre environnement et les personnes dans le besoin. Puissiez-vous être abondamment béni pour votre travail assidu.
For more information about the Honorable Louis Ng Kok Kwang, please visit parliament.gov.sg.
Aimables téléspectateurs, merci d'avoir été de nôtre aujourd'hui. À suivre.
Compassion pour tous les chevaux.
Horse plus Human Society, troisième et dernière partie, juste après les nouvelles d'exception. Puisse votre lumière intérieure resplendir et puissiez-vous être toujours protégé par les immenses bénédictions et la grâce de Dieu.
Good-natured viewers, thank you for your presence today. Coming up next is Compassion for All Equines, Horse plus Human Society, part 3 of 3. Right after noteworthy news. May your inner light shine and may you always be protected by the immense blessings and grace of God.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/gg.